Hi, welcome to this video about OMA 365. OMA, or Object Manager Advanced, has always been the leading development tool in a NAV/PC environment. And guess what? It comes as an app. Let me show you some super functionality. First, the extension itself. OMA 365, now running in my BC18 environment, is available as an extension, and we've added a small demo project to do some Object Manager advanced functionality later on, like guideline checks and where used analysis. But first, let's show you some base functionality that has always been a fantastic part of OMA. Analysis tools, where used analysis. And of course, it does not only access your own custom applications, but of course, it also accesses smoothly with the base application. So if we access the customer table here, we have on top all the global knowledge that we have about the customer table, and down here, the detailed information about keys, about fields, etc. Everything that comes with the on-prem classic OMA versions is also part of this brand new app. Which brings me to a few additional features that are part of this app and not part of the traditional OMA, but real cool new features. So for example, if we take a look at our Object Explorer and we again select the customer table and, for example, run it, showing you the data, of course. Now, one of the additional things that have been added to OMA 365 is the ability to directly access the functions that are part of the base application directly. So instead of programming temporary code units and objects like that to access the functions for whatever debugging reasons you might have, it's just a matter of selecting the functions and run it out of the box. A very, very cool additional functionality on top of what OMA already could do for decades. Now, as promised, I have a little example project to show you the project here. This is a normal, very small custom application. Hello World application, as you may recognize it. But as you can see here, there is a missing semicolon, and that's exactly done on purpose because I want OMA to either both detect that and make sure you're going to fix your, let's see, cosmetic problems. So for example, if we go back to the main role, developer role center of OMA, and we take analysis tools and guideline checks, then you will see, I already prepared the appearance of this object here, that there is one comment currently part of your extension programming. You can access that by drilling down to the problem. It detects the fact that you have a missing semicolon. You could also even add the code from here, access the code, seeing it directly here. But suppose you take the decision in analyzing this problem, and then you make sure you fix your little issue, save it, go back to OMA, and recheck your problem, then suddenly it's gone. So out of the box, completely automatic, since this extension is part of the OMA installation in this database, OMA immediately triggers and detects the fact that your little guideline violation, as we usually call them, is gone. And to show you some more integration possibilities, if we go to the Object Explorer again and hover to our latest touched objects, very cool feature, by the way, that you can sort based on the usage or the latest usage of your objects and not just top down from an object perspective. If we now access the history of this object, here we see the latest and the pre-latest version down here. We immediately have access from this environment to compare the actual difference. So what you can see here is exactly the problem and the new fixed solution. So it's not only Object Manager Advanced, there's also integration with, for example, an external or third-party compare tool. So it makes the code analysis and working with OMA MPC even more effective. So in a nutshell, the main message of this video, OMA is not gone, OMA is there as an app, fully integrated with any BC version you may have running as an extension. Very, very cool. Check it out on our website, www.idyn.nl.